how do you building a competitive edge through STEM? So we accumulated many experiences over the years. And so today we'll share some of this experience with our community. Now, over the last 2 months or so, and you can see that the news are overwhelming. There's a lot of information, and College Board is going to have an alternative test to national merits, and SAT subject test has been canceled. And there's a surge in applications, and the Ivy has, you know, and so there's a lot of information that's news, just like overwhelming. It's almost dizzying. Is how do you digest this information? So from parents' point of view is that don't panic, don't chase in the news, don't react right away. But the more focus on is the long-term trend in the admission and projecting out. Trend number one is that no matter what the situation is, the college admission is going to be more and more competitive. Right? So the key here is for parents to think about is that the competition is given, but don't overreacting and focus on is how do we train our children and students into a more, you know, a better, well-rounded human being. Yeah? So using this journey as a way to developing the skills that's necessary, not only will help them to benefit in college admission, but benefit in life. The second thing is that this testing is optional, right? Test optional, which means that many schools are no longer require SATs and ACTs. So a portion of that, that your school grades and your AP grades starting to count a little bit more. And the rest of the other application start to count a little bit more. So how do we adjust to that? Number three is there is a gradually shifting on quality over quantity. Okay. 15, 20 years ago, and it's all the rage is about on academic side, students competing on how many number of APs do you take? And we have regularly hear students who has 16 APs, 17 APs, 18 APs, and to get into the top college. And how much activities do you have? So students are starting clubs left and right and have a very, very long list of activities. And that no longer valid in today's world. Today's world is that you need for focus. Yeah. The number of APs is no longer a numbers game. So you don't need to chasing every AP. Instead, is you saving the time on those AP to pursue other activities that makes more sense. Well, what are things that makes more sense is your care for the others and doing common good. In our current society, we have so many problems. Everywhere you look in your local community, you will find the problems. So now, can you use what you learned to help solve these problems, right? What you learned not necessarily be science. You know, you can use your scientific knowledge to solve the problem. You can use your organization knowledge to solve the problem. You can use your passion to solve the problem. Whatever you do, okay, the college prefer students who are willing to contribute a part of their time and their energy to solve the problems in their community and to helping to do common good instead of doing everything for their own benefit. And the last one is that more and more students will apply early. Well, why more and more students will apply early? Because apply early has an advantage. Apply early has a much higher rate of admission. So for example, Stanford, overall admission is a little bit over 4, right? Regular admission is only 2.7%. But early admission is 8-point-something, right? So these schools, except MIT, all other schools, you apply early, you have a much higher chance. Yeah. So that's why more and more people are apply early. Apply early, that means a lot of things you need to prepare early. You cannot wait until your 11th grade to make a lot of decisions. What major would you like? You know, what are the activities you want to showcase yourself? All those things pretty much need to be done in 10th, 11th grade. So that way you can apply early. Not only for these Stanford's and Harvard's, there's also another group of skill is that if you apply early and they accept you, okay, and that's it, that's the school you can go to, right? So these are Brown's, Cornell's, Penn's, and Columbia, right? So you can see that they accept almost 50% of their students in the early round. And some of these, like Cornell, it's almost 25% in the ratio. So with all these trends, so the key is that the trend is going to go there. We believe these five trends will continue for the next 5-10 years. So the question for parents that you have a college-bound students is, how do you take care of this trend and work on that?